Hi, I'm Aaron Martens. I'm here on the lake right now, and I'm actually going to explain this new hook. I cut a new tournament grade hook out. All the years I've fished, I have experimented with other hooks over the years, and over the years, I've found that the O'Shaughnessy worm hook for me, as far as for drop shotting and split shotting and Texas rigging, to me was always superior. And I started putting in my football head jigs and a lot of my casting jigs. And I told Gamakatsu, you know, years ago, I've been talking to him, kind of begging him for Gamakatsu to make a O'Shaughnessy treble hook. And that was before short shanks came into play. Well, they came out with the short shank, the new one, and it was really, really good, but it still wasn't O'Shaughnessy. So over the last couple of years, or 3 or 4 years, I really started getting on him about making a short shank with the O'Shaughnessy bend. Because it's, to me, O'Shaughnessy, if you can get that, what it is the bend is not round. It actually has, it's kind of round at the bottom, and it kind of shuts off towards the point and goes straight. What that does is when a fish gets hooked, when they throw a bait, or say you're throwing a spoon or a crankbait, and they come up and jump, shake real hard, the round bend, they get leverage. And if you got one hook on them, it tends to kind of loop out, even if you have a lot of pressure on them. The O'Shaughnessy hook doesn't do that. You notice right away, just fishing O'Shaughnessy, that when the fish jumps, you hardly ever lose them. You can like slack line them, they can jump all they want. You can barbless the hooks and it don't matter. They can't get the leverage they need to throw that bait off. It actually hits that bend where the O'Shaughnessy makes that sharp bend and actually stops the hook from leaving the fish's mouth. So they made this new hook, it's a tournament grade. And the first thing you're gonna notice is the color. It's a kind of a gray, kind of a, I wanted something not black, because black stands out so much, and chrome, you know, chrome's kind of flashing, you don't always want that. You just want your bait to show. So this is a kind of an in-between, which makes it really stealth. And that's a nano coat they put on it. It also makes it a lot slicker. And the penetration, the thing you're really going to notice when you look at it, it's got little barbs on it. And I went back and forth with Gamakatsu, and Gamakatsu is really into penetration. Like the hook actually, when it hits a fish, it goes all the way to the bend. And I've been using this hook 2 years now, prototypes, and over the last year, first year I had them, and they were phenomenal. I lost hardly any fish the whole season, less than I've ever lost in a season to actually go back to it. But you are going to notice that barbs are small, and the only thing I can tell you is don't be scared of that. You know, right now we have 5 sizes I'm working on, up to trying again to make them up to a 3-aught, so we'll have a really good spoon hook, or for really big baits, you know, the big hooks. But the best way to try it is just, you know, you really have to just try it and put it on a bait and go throw it and catch some fish on it, and you'll see it's really, really good. And also another thing I want to tell you, it's tournament grade steel, so the steel is 20% stronger. You're going to notice this hook's about the same size as a lot of the hooks that have been out there over the years we've used. But, you know, a lot of times those old hooks in the past would open up, or you'd bend them on a fish. You'd get one hook in a fish and be pulling on 12-pound line, a size 4, and the fish would pull real hard, and your hook would come unattached from the fish, and you'd bring it in, the hook is straightened out. This hook doesn't do that. This is 20% stronger steel. So for the same diameter, it's 20% stronger, which is a lot if you think about it. But that's a new tournament grade nano-coated treble hook.